What's up, shooters? Anastas here, and in this video, we'll be covering how to study big production music videos most commonly found on YouTube. First and foremost, what are you looking for when dissecting someone else's edit? Pay attention to the number of locations, the number of performance scenes, tripod scenes, different types of gimbal and handheld shots, cinematography behind the storylines, and visual effects. Let's use Cole Bennett's video he directed for Lil Xan, Betrayed. Now, I know Lil Xan has kind of fallen off in the music industry, but we're not going for a reaction on the actual music video itself. I'm going to be dissecting this video down for you to show you how a story was told in what appears to be just one location, and how Cole Bennett of Lyrical Lemonade directed a simple yet clean music video using all of the techniques we preach in our music video course. Shameless plug. Now, one thing to take note of when you are editing music videos is coming up with creative ideas to place the artist's name and song name title on the screen during the first 7 seconds of the video, as well as having the artist's name and their song title pop up creatively according to the beat of the song. Alright guys, so we got camera angle number one, Lil Xan holding the camera and doing a performance scene to it. Pop the trunk, open up, I sold my soul a good price, out of sight, my whole got talent. Now, because this is such a unique camera angle, when the beat of the song hits, Cole's editing direction highlights the beat drop to be a performance scene right off the hop of Lil Xan performing with this really clean camera angle. Rather than having an extended camera angle, as we haven't seen a performance scene switch up for a few lines, Cole adds in visual effects in the background to keep the viewer engaged through the extended performance scene. Camera angle number two, Lil Xan standing up against a wall that appears to be in a tight space. I'm a businessman and then my bennet damn, and I'ma bend it down, then I'ma lick her up, and then dig her down, she gon' turn around, and I'ma using an overhead light right above his head that casts a shadow on his eyes, giving him owl eyes. The mixture of the owl eyes and the psychology behind the dark color shade of blue being isolation, passivity, and calmness gives the entire vibe of this video a feeling of being alone, which is what Lil Xan is rapping about in this song. We can also note that this appears to be a handheld shot slowly tracking in on Lil Xan's movements and using a wall as the foreground throughout the shot. One other thing I want to mention about camera angle number two is this camera angle performance scene is also an extended and very long performance scene, so Cole added animated hearts falling down the screen that sort of go along with the lyrics. Again, being a slow handheld movement shot, he breaks this 9 to 10 second performance scene up with a tasteful amount of animation. I also noticed that when watching this video a few times over that Cole was probably a little creatively burnt out and accidentally placed a different watermark logo in the bottom right corner of the screen right above the clickable subscribe button. Oh, what? That's our Learn Freelance Filmmaking logo. Damn, shout out to Cole Bennett for tossing in a little Easter egg in one of his edits. I guess I could also mention that this video is one of 200 music video lessons found in our online music video course that's built for freelancers like yourself. If you want to learn more about our course, click the first link you see in the description of this video. And guys, we really do spend a lot of time producing these free YouTube videos to help educate up-and-coming freelancers like yourself to level up your video game. If you could do us a solid by hitting that like button, we're really trying to get this video to 500 likes because this type of music video tutorial hasn't even been touched on YouTube yet. And by liking the video, it helps this video reach other filmmakers who could really use this information to level up their game. Now, moving on to camera angle number three. Slightly pointing the camera up towards Lil Xan at a tight camera angle where I'm sure Lil Xan was directed to sway his head back and forth, to which Cole punches his lens in just far enough so Lil Xan's head sways in and out of frame. Holy son, I were the chosen one, I'm sipping out the grass, don't kiss the touch, keep my wish, well, I don't need a way. A noteworthy B-roll shot I want to mention is the shot where Lil Xan's feet are hanging in the top half of the screen, and all you see is the floor on the bottom of the screen, while Cole keyframes in on the frame with a slight twisting motion to the left. This B-roll shot breaks apart the performance scenes and transitions to a new environment. Camera angle number four, the table shots are now introduced with a performance scene, which appears that Cole had his camera sitting on top of the table filming Lil Xan singing along to the song while Cole pulls focus back and forth from an object on the table to Lil Xan, but take note that he's pulling focus to the beat of the song, which is super creative. My energy, like I ain't dead, yeah, I an foreign bitch, think she into me. Camera angle number five, close-up face shot with a lighter shade of blue with a very slight handheld natural motion. Camera angle number six. Now we punch out to a wider angle focal length with Lil Xan's feet kicked up on the table. Camera angle number 7, we have another stationary keyframing in shot, most likely off of a tripod, and this one is a little unorthodox. Considering the song is moody and eerie, the awkward angle of Lil Xan laying down and not having him in center frame really fits the vibe of the song and the music video. Notable performance scenes to mention. For every line of these 4 back-to-back performance scenes, notice the keyframing. The first scene keyframes in on the chorus, and the second, third, and fourth scenes keyframe out slowly. The keyframe in on the first scene of the chorus and the following 3 performance scenes all keyframe out, which creates a smooth look and transition from scene to scene. Camera angle number 8, Lil Xan in the bottom left of the screen with a ton of open space and purple color palette. Camera angle number 9, another unorthodox shot where Lil Xan is now in the left thirds on a 45 degree angle, facing away from the camera doing a performance scene. Very unorthodox, but it looks super dope and it just fits the vibe of the music video. Again, very unorthodox, not something I would think of because it is so kind of against the rules of filmmaking, but you know, music videos, you can let your creativity run wild. Now, 3 B-roll shots I didn't mention were the cup of soup in the microwave, Lil Xan's hand with animated lyrics behind them on the table, and the tap water running in the sink. Cole sprinkled maybe 4 or 5 B-roll shots into this entire video, yet it was still so engaging. And by the looks of it, this looked like it was all filmed in one location, but still had 9 different camera angles for performance scenes. Cole Bennett, from my understanding, from studying his videos, implements a lot of handheld and tripod shots more than gimbal or steadicam shots. I feel he only uses certain techniques of filmmaking that make sense for the environment and shot he's looking for. Okay, so an amateur music videographer's approach at this video would be to film a few performance scenes at 24fps and a few B-roll shots for slow motion cutaways, which in my opinion would butcher the final edit due to the fact that you're handcuffed to one location and aren't maximizing the location to its full potential. Not to mention, I picked up on a lot of unorthodox filming techniques and compositions throughout this music video edit, and guess what? That's totally okay, because the beauty of music videos is that there is no right or wrong way to film them. Them, which in my opinion is why music videos are such a saturated area for filmmakers to tap into. Most important takeaway of this video and dissecting other people's music videos is that you can now have a better understanding of how to dissect the work of your local competition. So really, when you're dissecting videos, all you really want to look out for is how these filmmakers are composing their shots, being able to pick apart whether the filmmaker is using a handheld, gimbal, or tripod shot, the number of locations, and the continuity between scenes, as well as their lighting techniques. And before you leave, remember guys, if you don't subscribe to the channel, please do so, as we sink a lot of time into providing our viewers with free videography tips to help you take your filmmaking game to the next level. We appreciate you guys for checking out the video, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.